Okay, so the purpose of this instructional video is I want to show you how the point-slope formula is developed from the regular slope formula. Now, the regular slope formula is m equals y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. And the basic idea here is you find two points on the graph, subtract the rise, subtract the run, then divide the ratio. So it'd be kind of like, let me put a point here. Okay, so we have this x1, y1, which is 1, 3, and then we have 2, 5, this other point, and we would subtract the y's, subtract the x's, and divide, and that'll give you a rise over run, which in this case is actually 2. Okay, now let me show you how you can take this slope formula and create a function out of it. What I'm going to do is instead of y2 and x2, I'm just going to put y and x for the output and input. So m equals y minus y1 divided by x minus x1. Okay, now that's it. We now have a function, but it's still in the form of the slope formula, and that's not particularly useful. So you can do a little algebra and make the point slope formula. Okay, so let me work this out for a particular case first so you can make sense of the algebra a little bit, and then we'll go back and finish this with a general formula. So our m, for our particular case here, we know is 2. So I'm going to put 2 equals, and then y minus, and for the y1 value, I'm going to use this 5 from the 0.25 that's on the line. And for the x minus, and then the x value, I'm going to use 2. Like that. Okay, so this formula, even though it's kind of a weird form, it should fit this equation here. I'll put 2 over 1 and cross multiply. So we're going to get 1 times y minus 5, or just y minus 5, equals, and then 2 times x minus 2. And I use parentheses because it's 2 times the whole thing, the x and the minus 2. This is point slope form right here. See how simple that is? And of course, if you want to have slope intercept form, you just distribute the 2 and then you're going to add the 5. So let's do that. So it's 2 times x is 2x. First I'll put y minus 5, 2x. And then 2 times negative 2 is negative 4. Then I'm going to add 5 to both sides. And I finish this up here. So it's going to be y equals 2x, and then negative 4 plus 5 is plus 1. How's that? Well, our slope is 2, intercept here is 1, so that's good. This linear equation fits. So let's review the process. Started off with a slope formula, modified to create a general function, the 2 for the slope and the 2 comma 5 point, the 2 for the x, 5 for y. Made a proportion, cross multiplied, and then simplified from there. So here I'm just going to show you the one step right here to create the point slope formula. There's your proportion, cross multiply. 1 times y minus y1 is going to be y minus y1, and then that's going to be equal to m times the quantity of x minus x1, because you're multiplying m by both of those. That's all it is. There's your point slope formula. So you're taking your slope formula, putting a y and an x instead of y2, x2, and then you just cross multiply. That's it. And this is a really handy formula when you have a point and a slope and you need to write a linear function, because you can easily input the m for the slope, the point x1, y1, and then do some simple algebra and you have yourself your equation.